Action.
Looks perfect. Welcome to my office. Have absolute peace and quiet in here. There's a cat in here. Oh no, wait, the cat's missing.
Is it graffiti? Ah!
Wow.
Now, he is just, that is called urban camouflage. No one's gonna notice, you guys. That happens in Ratchet and Clank all the time. All the time. But if you really want to fix it, okay. I'm kidding, we gotta fix it.
I don't want to come off as like, oh, failure is not an option, but we really do like it's gotta be good, so we keep working on it.
The issue goes away, but so do some of the, you know, actual graphics that go along with it. So that's one way of fixing flickering, right? You just remove the graphics.
Problem
but,
solved.
I mean, on the high level, the way I see this phase of the project specifically, where it's more like about, you know, you get bugs and you need to fix them. It's like you spend 90% of the time investigating, like just researching what is actually happening. And often when you know what's happening, the actual fix is pretty easy. And so what it comes down to is just a lot of like detective work.
Like somehow a regret dies under a figment and that transfers the burnt state to the figment. I haven't reproduced it yet, but that's my current operating theory. Being in that what is like the home stretch, because like it's been just out of reach for so long, and now that we're finally here, it's like it's so normal, but at the same time it's also very surreal. Like the idea that this is going to be finished, and like that there is a life on the other side of Psychonauts too. You know,
I did it.
You figured it out, Dan.
You were right. I had to get a doubt to run over the figment. And then when I lit the doubt on fire, it swapped the figment's material. But what the hell?
The fire propagation system is causing things that aren't supposed to burn to burn.
Genius idea, Tazio.
Overall, like, I am feeling, knock on everything, like, pretty confident about where things are.
We were really just looking for, like, critical bugs that completely crashed the game or blocked progression in some sort of unrecoverable way. So it's been fun to do that, playing the game at home and trying to break it in as many ways as possible.
Well, I mean, people have called out that you're like one of the bug-finding superstars.
I think when Naoko told people to start breaking it, you know, like, it was almost like a call, like, like accept the challenge or not, you know? It's just a feeling, like, you get the feeling of Raz, and you're like, yeah, like, I see a distance, and I'm judging in the game, like, I'm pretty sure I could make that. One instance I'll make it and I'm like, okay, well, it's possible, so, you know, there you go. Then maybe it's time to report this and just see if the team wants to fix it or not. You know, that's how I found some of the worst ones, where you can jump out of the world and see a lot of crazy things.
No, I mean, I want to credit like production for enforcing, you know, and Key, you know, our lead programmer, lead producer, Key and Naoko are pushing for, you know, a real rational approach to how many tasks we're doing.
The only thing I've been told that I have to figure out is like, it has to be done and we have to submit it this date. And I'm like, not later. And I'm told no. So just trying to find a path to what's the responsible action.
In the old days, we might have fixed everything, but now we have this daily triage meeting where we're like really fight over what we're going to, we should fix that. Oh, we don't need to fix that. We can fix that in a patch.
I think I noticed it in this is the suitcase, huh? What?
Can we pass
Why is this shape?
Weird.
Taking that very seriously so that we don't destabilize the build. And so the build's more stable. And as we come into a landing, it probably still feels really chaotic for Naoko, but for me, it feels a lot less chaotic than I'm used to.
I do really appreciate that folks are very like mindful of each bug's kind of relevance in the whole scope of the game. Otherwise, chasing down every single one of these would cause so many other bugs when you try to fix them.
She's also respawning inside the bad zone, though.
won't happen anymore.
That was the bug that was fixed.
So what can you still do?
You can walk behind the counter because they didn't put the counter against the wall.
Okay. But you can't get stuck there.
You don't get stuck.
Okay, so we're done. We're done. Yeah.
That's all of them for right now until tomorrow.
Bug free.
I think right now we're trying to keep an eye on the things that would distract the player and prioritize those over the little things that annoy us that we wish we had time to go back to but aren't necessarily going to stop or distract the player.
I mean, there's stuff like in the HQ that like I wanted to fix, but I've kind of like I've accepted the fact that like we can't fix it anymore. There's like we're at the point where we just got to get the game out.
Part of this whole like process is learning. This is like the ultimate test of learning to let go. Like, let it go. It's okay.
Probably we're so nitpicky that 99% of people won't even notice that thing that we're spending a half hour talking about whether we should fix it or not. So, but it's great to be at that point where you're nitpicking just the teeny tiniest thing to see if you want to actually do something about it.
I think it's great. But you do, not being in the office, you do miss a lot of that, just the energy of being in the room and seeing people work. Like, you know, we'd walk by Key's desk and if Key's holding a can of cold soda to his head from the fridge, that means that it's he's got a really bad bug and a headache. And so you kind of pick up on these signs that you miss when you're doing it over a video conference.
Well, why is she just popping to her shake attack?
These are questions.
Yeah.
It's very separate. It's very physically separate. So it doesn't kind of quite get the same feeling as it would be in the office. It's a really strange way to close out a game. I've never done it like this before, and I'm not sure if I ever really want to do it again this way. So my hope is that, you know, we are at a place where we can just kind of leave the build alone through Wednesday and Thursday, and then we submit on Friday. There hasn't been anything that pops up that has been like super, super concerning. So that's how where the build feels like it is at right now. Yeah.
Great.
Sounds fantastic.
It's a weird mix of emotions. You have relief. Wait, let me check the bug channel again. Okay, you have relief that things are going. And just even typing out release candidate felt like such a weird thing because, you know, it's been a long road and we've been doing this for a long time and it's been really hard. And just calling something as being the thing that we are done is, it was oddly, just, that was the most triumphant thing I felt in typing out two words before. But this is a product of the last 5 years of our lives, of all the, our collective shared experiences together. And knowing that those 5 years culminated in this thing, it's more about the making of it than what we've created. And I think it is just is a bonus that what we created is something that we feel is great.
I'm amazed at how it has come together.
I can't believe we made a real game.
It feels great. It honestly feels great.
Excuse me if I curse. It's a fucking beautiful game. I was gonna say that straight out. It looks amazing.
I'm definitely gonna be like day one hopping into Twitch streams and just, I wanna see people's reactions.
I think people are going to like this. I think people who are fans of the series are really gonna like it.
Cause I was worried. I was really worried. I'm not as worried anymore. I was really worried, you know, and I may have mentioned this, you know, when we started this new game, are we going to be able to recreate that feeling that people had when they played the first one?
There's people with a lot of fond memories of the game, and they want that again. And that's very, I think that's really hard to give people.
And you think about some of those people were just kids that played, like really young kids that played it, and now they're adults. I think it's going to fit very well with that audience, so. I'm pretty excited for people to see it.
But I'm hoping that they'll see that just as much love and attention went into this one as the first one. So hopefully it'll just feel like they just picked up the day after Psychonauts, which is exactly where it starts.
Probably just retire after this. Like, financially, I'll be pretty set. You know, I'm expecting a lot of royalties.
Great. Thank you, Carol. On the project, Naoko, do you have any news since last Friday? I think our last meeting, since our last meeting, we did something like ship or something.
Well, we submitted and it
shipped. Done. Yet. Done. Go home. Everyone go home. It's all over. It's easy.
No news is good news.
Games are easy.
See, if you delay your game enough, it's always on time. In the end, it's always on time when it ships.
Today is the week of, I think, the Tomley's party, right? We're all going to celebrate our anniversary of still being around after 21 years.
Tommy's, the Double Fine birthday party. Yeah, I mean, I'm definitely looking forward to it. Like, it's, you know, there's nothing like a pandemic and working from home to make you realize how much you miss people.
Are you documenting right now?
So Tommy's is great. Seeing, of course, all of our old friends, and but then Raz walked by. Raz doesn't even work at the company anymore, and he was just going to get food. Lives in the neighborhood, and so Raz, out of the blue, I haven't seen him in years, and so he was hanging out. So it was very surreal. And Ray flew out. You know,
it was nice to hug people. Gave a lot of hugs, and yeah, felt good. Felt like going back, you know, to old friends. A lot of longer and grayer hair, which was interesting.
It was really nice to be together. I still, like I said to my toast, a lot, this is a company that likes to be together.
Even though over the years, a lot of forces have tried to make us not be together, but we are still here. We have survived 21 years of the games industry. We have survived COVID-19. Yeah, and we have survived Psychonauts 2. I feel like we've really made something that's gonna matter to people, that really people are gonna like, and are gonna come up to you 10 years from now at a trade show and say, you worked on that game? That game meant a lot to me. And I think that is because of all the hard work of this team, and not just one magic thing, but a million things that everyone did every day. Not just surviving, but making it great. And thank you for 21 amazing years. Thank you, everybody. Cheers. Happy birthday.
How did you make it sound genuine? It sounded so genuine.
I know you're not used to this.
Emotion?
Well done, well done.
Some people afterwards were like, wow, that was a very sincere toast you made. I was like, what? I'm always sincere. Why was that one different? I'm playing through it now, and I'm thinking about early ideas about this story, about Ford, and about your family, and It's unbelievable that these old plans finally pay off, you know, years later. I just hope people like it. I'm not afraid of people playing it. It's a good position to be in when you're shipping a game. I'm not afraid of people playing it.